But our story really doesn't start in Ephrata. In fact, it starts in a little town called Eberbach, Germany. And today, Eberbach is about the same size as the modern-day Ephrata. It's located along the Neckar River, and it's a very old town. This image shows it as the walled city, and portions of that wall still survive. And any of you who have had opportunity to visit Eberbach may recognize some things such as the tower. There's something called the Powder Tower right here. And there's something called the Hat Tower, which is right over here. So you see, they still exist today. It was in Eberbach in 1691 when Conrad Beisel was born. He was the last of 10 children. He never knew his father. His father had died a few months before he was born. His mother died when he was 8 years old. And while this image of the town looks fairly pleasant, it really wasn't in those days. It was in the center of a region known as the Palatinate in Germany, and it was an area that was absolutely devastated by a series of wars. The biggest, the 30 Years' War, ended in 1648, and it took that area almost 100 years to reach its population that it had prior to the war. There were a couple of other wars late in the 17th century, and they all affected Beisel's life. He was taken around to be raised by other brothers and sisters and aunts and uncles, probably only had about 3 or so years of formal schooling by his uncle in a neighboring town. As a young man, Beisel learned to be a baker. That was his father's trade, his grandfather's trade, so it seemed natural. And to learn the craft, he was required to travel to other towns and work with other bakers. In his travels, he eventually wound up in Heidelberg, the capital of that region. And when he arrived, he was introduced to a group of people known as the Pietists. Now, the Pietists were part of a religious movement, not a separate independent church, but a group of people within established churches who sought to kind of further the Reformation that had begun centuries earlier. The Pietists wanted to use the Bible as a guide for living, and they wanted to live a very simple life, and they called one another brother and sister. They liked to have little gatherings to study the Bible and sing and pray. The problem was those gatherings were illegal. Remember, there's no separation of church and state in Europe at this time. And the minister is also a government official. And you can't have a meeting without a government official present. Well, without inviting the minister to these little gatherings, the Pietists were breaking the law. So they would hide in the forests and in attics and other sorts of areas to gather to have their worship services together. They got them in trouble, and many Pietists were thrown out of the areas where they were living. Beisel was thrown out of Heidelberg. He traveled around a bit, met another group of people called the Community of True Inspiration, who believed there were living prophets. But he didn't fit too well with them, so a friend encouraged him to come to Pennsylvania. And this image of the Philadelphia from the harbor was painted in 1720, the same year that Conrad Beisel arrived. So this is the image he would have seen coming into the harbor of Philadelphia. And it wasn't quite the giant city that it would become, but it was still a very important city full of a great diversity of people, ideas, languages, backgrounds. In fact, one immigrant called the ship he came on a Noah's Ark of people who had come to settle this new land. Beisel didn't find a home in Philadelphia, but north of it, several miles in Germantown, with Peter Becker. Becker had been the leader of the Church of the Brethren, and he had brought some of his followers here to America the year before Beisel arrived. Beisel spent the winter with Becker, but he was still restless. So in 1721, he moved out to the Conestoga region, right along the Mill Creek, just outside of Burdenhand. And it was there that he decided to try and live as a hermit. But he was also introduced to the ideas of the Church of the Brethren. Becker was the leader of the Church of the Brethren, so it seemed a natural fit, and he, in fact, was baptized and joined the church in 1724. But he still struggled with his own ideas and things he was reading and discussing with other people.